Hello and welcome. This is Greg Schmiedl, Product Manager of Anti-Audio's Flexus line. Today we will show you the new LabVIEW driver for the FX100 Audio Analyzer. With me today is my colleague Florian Mattis. He's the author of the driver and will guide you through this presentation.
LabVIEW is a graphical programming language designed by National Instruments and is amongst the popular solutions in measurement, control and regulation systems. We created the driver using the available .NET API for the Flexus line and can therefore provide an update-proof solution for your LabVIEW applications.
We will start with a new and empty VI. To access the driver, go to the Functions palette by right-clicking on the block diagram. You then will find the driver in the Instrument I/O section. Using the instrument driver, an application always starts with the initialize VI in order to connect to the device. Then, we want to configure the generator level. We can find this VI in the configure generator section. When you move the cursor over the VI, you will see the full name. To adjust the glide sweep settings of the generator, we add the configured generator glide sweep VI to the block diagram. The next step is to activate a glide sweep level measurement. After configuring the instrument, we want to execute a single measurement with this VI in the action status section of the driver. To receive the results of the actual measurement, the result VIs are used. Last, we want to close the connection to the driver by using the close VI. The next step is to connect the VIs with the error and .NET reference using wires. Each VI has several different input and output terminals, which are most based on enumeration values of the Flexus API. Because of that, you can easily create a control with all available options by simply right-clicking on the desired terminal and then selecting Control. LabVIEW will automatically create a control on the front panel with all possible options to choose from. If you do not want to let the user change a value, you should use the constant value. We will now add some basic setting controls. Our first measurement application is the Flexus instrument driver. We will now have a look at the front panel. LabVIEW put the controls just anywhere on the panel. We can reorder our controls and indicators to our needs. To display our level measurement result, we will use a graph. To do so, we choose a XY graph from the LabVIEW controls palette on the front panel and adjust the labels for the axis. Also, since we want to display decibel values, we change the x-axis to a logarithmic scale. Back on the block diagram, we will first bundle the data and then create an array which is fed into the graph input. We will now adjust the default configuration of the instrument and apply some example values before we click on the Run button to start. After that, we can see that our graph was updated with the results of the glide sweep level measurement. This was a quick introduction how you can use our instrument driver to easily create applications and measurements. Some example applications are attached to the driver. This one is a glide sweep level measurement. As you can see at the block diagram, all applications are structured in the same way. They initialize at the start, configuring the instrument, enable the measurement options, acquisition of the data, and then display the results. Last, the closing of the connection.
Thank you, Florian. The LabVIEW driver and the user manual for it can be downloaded free of charge from our myntiaudio.com website. If you need any further information or support, please let us know. Thanks for your attention. Goodbye.